final achievement. So, if you were just watching on YouTube, thank you for watching. And if you just started watching on YouTube, welcome to another random run. It's Kane. Why don't we start with Kane, the lucky foot? I'm accidentally doing a greed mode run. That is my mistake. I still done that because that was also my mistake. But we did seem to start with... We must have had Eden's Blessing the last time I played this game, which was such a long time ago that even my grandchildren are old and grey. But it looks like we had Eden's Blessing, and therefore now we have the Piggy Bank, which is actually pretty good, because if you get hit at any point, please hit that dip. Thank you. We stand a chance of spawning some money, and money is what makes the greed mode go round. Let's not trap ourselves in a corner full of spiders. Pardon me? That exploded because of who? Right, so here's a funny story. You can, when the enemies spawn, they can explode bombs and rocks and things. So if you're standing next to a explodey barrel, you may find yourself in a sorry situation. I am on 6 of 10 waves and I cannot beat this. Help, 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 help. Right, you kill each other. That's going to be amazing. If I stand over here, I stand a good chance of not being hit by every shot on the screen at once! Not greed mode, please. Let's try that again. What you say? Second. But I didn't mean to do that. I didn't intend to do a greed mode. I wasn't paying attention. We've rolled Azazel, which makes me feel quite happy because it means that I can just get through a run. For the first time in my adult life, because I'm incapable of playing this fucking game. And possibly do well. Yeah, Yum Heart. You know what? I haven't got an item. I'll take it. What am I going to use it for? Fuck all. We don't even have red hearts. We have a fool card. This will get us out of boss rush. I do like not playing the daily run. It really makes me happy. But I also like not playing greed mode when I wasn't expecting to play greed mode. Especially when greed mode is exploding barrels in my face and then going trollolol, now you can't step on the button. So you're going to die anyway. Brilliant. Tum-ti-tum. Right, there's our bomb. That gets us the... I was going to say spirit heart, but it's just a tinted rock that's in this other room. But we'll go this way first. It is a lot of bad people. What is it? This whole game is out to get me today. This is super gluttony on the first fucking floor. Another bomb though. Hopefully two spirit hearts out of this, because I took half a heart of damage just now. Or the small rock, that would be really good too. Yeah, two spirit hearts, that's really good. Because that means that we can take a deal with the devil and not worry about the consequences. Such a great deal. I mean, being Azazel, you can generally count on getting through most floors without taking too much damage anyway. Especially when enemies are being bullshit. Seriously though. Excuse me, you just made a champion immolator topper. I'm pretty sure that I did not agree to this. Which turned into two more fucking immolator toppers, which are no doubt going to jump across the screen at me. Flatworm does nothing. Oh well. Let's fight this boss. Get the salt out of my system. This little horn who will kill himself. Not properly. So when it does that one, maybe you just stand near it? Yes, we'll take experimental treatment. It gave us some HP, which... Yeah, that's pretty good, because it means that we can sell it to the devil. Which we're basically guaranteed to get. I am playing a little bit fast and loose. I'm playing a little bit... I want to get it out of my system that greed mode was bullshit and that I tried to do the hush in 15 minutes. Just watching my life tick by. I'm going to save my money and not go to that shop. Could give us an arcade on this floor, and with a... It did. And with a sufficient amount of HP, or even an invincibility rune or card, or even pill. Wow. We could get a lot out of that arcade, because it does have a Demon Beggar in it. Demon Judgment, I should say. So any red hearts at all? That one exploded. Probably didn't really count on that. A Perthro rune. Could be good. Let's take it to all of our item type runes. Any red hearts, please, so that I can... Yeah, we'll take that. So that I can use my red heart on the deal with the devil. That becomes an option, because if I don't have anything in this red heart container, I can't use the red heart on the deal with the devil, because devil doesn't want empty heart containers unless it's empty heart containers and you have... It's inconsistent, but there's a rule. You have to have at least some red HP to be offered a red HP deal. And I mean red hearts in the containers, not just the container. So having an empty container means I'm going to be charged spirit hearts, which will kill me. Which means I will only be able to take... Just use the fucking yum heart, you dickhead. There we go. You've been talking about that. Let's take the yum heart. We don't know if we're going to make use out of it. Spend half an hour talking about the fact we don't have any red HP. Oh, of course, Curse of the Blind. Let's take this. It's Squeezy. I like Squeezy. It also gives us two spirit hearts. Okay. I guess we take one of them and see what it is. I hate this. There we go. Nine lives? Book of Sin. Spirit heart. No. Tears down. Brilliant. Well, we've got the Book of Sin. And I'm taking Horror of Babylon, which is actually really good. I should have re-rolled that, but we've got Perforin. It's okay. What, Gente? Cherry Pitter? What the fuck would I have a Cherry Pitter? The real people own Cherry Pitters, and you're the one who doesn't like Jamie Oliver. Jesus Christ. Do you have a... I don't even have a honey spoon thingy. Where's my item room, though? Here it is. Honey spoon. Sad bombs. Ah, I quite like spad bombs. Especially if it gives us real brimstone, which I'm not sure it does. But if it does, it's going to be amazing. Where are the chopsticks? It does not give us real brimstone. That's a shame. Knocking around? One of them baskets, maybe? I bought some chopsticks from Muji. I don't know where they are. Jen's found them because they were where I said they were. So I didn't know where they are. Except... for the bit where I was confident about where they are, which is, I mean, I knew where they were, but I was wrong about not knowing, which is better than being wrong about knowing, because obviously the enemy of knowledge is not ignorance, but the illusion of knowledge. Who said that? No, it wasn't Einstein, it was the new Einstein. Stephen Einstein. Stop spawning next to me, you fucking dicks. Seriously. The low range on Azazel really has to be dealt with ASAP, and we haven't. We have done nothing to deal with... I'll just take it. Nothing to deal with it, because we have had no opportunity to do that. And it can cause great issues, like when you're in the middle of a bunch of enemies that have suddenly rearranged themselves to spawn behind you. That was close. Or this one where the enemy will explode and you're too close to it because you can't get further away. Like a ranged downgrade at this point would be catastrophic. Perthro, Hagalaz. We could probably make use of the Hagalaz at some point. Perthro, I will reroll Epiphora into something we might as well take. It's Bomber Boy. It has five bombs associated with it. Now we have sad bombs that also do huge blast damage. Wow! Okay, that was definitely worth it. Every single fire that Bomber Boy produces is also a sad bomb. So we just produce an X of little explodey laser things. Please go this way. Thank you. That was pretty good. I don't know if shot speed increases our range as Azazel. No, it doesn't. But I'm just going to go to the next floor because I'm scared of this one. I did leave my full card behind. In preference, like, I prefer to reroll something. I'm not sure if that was a great idea. Because it means we can't get out of boss rush, but we do have the opportunity to find a teleport card later if we look. So we actually have to look. I didn't go to the shop on the previous floor. We didn't have 15 cents. I didn't want to spend the time looking around for 15 cents, basically. I feel like I should be salty about the fact I had two wins in a row and lost on a greed run, but I mean, I don't really feel like a greed run win counts anyway. As a win, so I don't feel like I had two real, like, valuable wins in a row, and two is not that many, and I'm really not going to try playing the streaks until we have 1001%, because that's the geek cred that actually allows you to be a streaker, and I think most people growing up aspire to become a streaker. I mean, I know I certainly did. Yeah, these spirit hearts from the Book of Sin are super helpful. Health up is also pretty good, so I'm happy I did that. Let's see if we can get a secret room here. We can. That's actually also really good. It means we can get into this. Ooh. Does this do what I want it to do? No. In that case, we'll take this. Because we do have... Is Curse of... Is the Horror of Babylon a... Oh, was there a key in there? That's what I wanted. Is the Horror of Babylon a an evil item? There's no key. This is unbelievable. We could spend 15 cents on not needing keys, which is actually an option at this stage. I will take as many bombs as I can because they're super cool right now. Our bombs are outrageous. They're great fun. I know that's not a secret room because I just went to the secret room. So, yeah, call me names if that's what you wish. Here's a key. Right, I'm going to use the key to go into the item room. Yeah, we could spend money on pay-to-play, which means that all our locked rooms become locked by coins. I think no, because our range is already saddened. As I noted before, if we get a range downgrade, that will be catastrophic, so pretty hypocritical to then take a range downgrade for what is essentially useless to us, because the tiers upgrade as Azazel with Brimstone is not as useful as the range as Azazel with the tiny Brimstone, because we're already firing more than fast enough to get our damage done. Another bomb is fine. So we're going to go in here. We're going to... Of course it's a stain. Why would you not be fighting the stain right now? But the stain died in one of those. Pageant boy. Let me just see what our deal with the devil holds. Unfortunately, we did not manage to get anything in that heart container. But fortunately, we are fighting Krampus. So our heart container's contents are irrelevant. We're not going to be spending our money. They're not money. Do we take Krampus's head? I think we don't, and the reason I think we don't is that we've got so many spirit hearts out of the Book of Sin, and it's kept us alive. Krampus' head is not that interesting. I guess we don't often take the Book of Sin, to be honest. Krampus' head is basically a long-range normal attack. It's basically a really, really bad Tammy's head at this stage, because we're Azazel. So we get a Krampus' head once every 6 rooms. And a Tammy's head is once every 1 room, and it's basically the same attack, give or take. See, there's another one of them, so I'm pretty vindicated right now. And that was a good chest to open. Alright. Holy crap. Jen's pulling faces at me and I'm not paying attention to the screen. What is up with you? She stabbed herself. She's the one who's a... She's a cook. Cooks are supposed to stab themselves. Look. It's just protein, yeah? Get blood in the pie, it's blood pie. It's not like it's, you know, unethically sourced or anything. Nah, don't want that. Our item rooms have been really shit recently, actually. That's 2 in a row that I've not wanted. And a deal with the devil I didn't want. Why have I got this Hagalaz rune, though? I guess because I haven't replaced it? It's still taking us a while to break these enemies apart as well, which is not filling me with confidence. I'm going to keep taking pills because I don't know what's good for me. One makes you small. A reference to the Jefferson Airplane song? Why? No. The other people. Stevie Nicks. Stevie Nicks? Fleetwood Mac. Fleetwood Mac song. White Rabbit. A little bit of trivia there. For anybody listening, which is nobody... According to chat. Wow. Nightlight just saved me from these jokers, which is actually really good. I'm a fan of Nightlight saving me from jokers. I wouldn't mind a joker card, actually. It can get us out of boss rush and give us the deal with the devil that we may not get. It's in the Croppers 1, so we can go in here. Oh, Mask of Infamy with this fucking bullshit range. What are you talking about? Put this down. Oh, no. One fucking shot. Brilliant. And we get another syringe, which is brilliant also. And I think we take... We've got 1 HP. We could take Cambion Conception. I think we just take Pentagram and leave Cambion Conception. I think the Pentagram does give you HP back. We've got so much time, though. We've gone so fast. We should find a shop. I think Pentagram gives you HP back, but I'm not certain. And I don't want to... really risky. I don't want to run the risk of dying just to pick up Cambion Conception, because we're not going to be really... we're not going to be intentionally spending HP. Yeah, that was not even a lucky guess. That was fairly obviously there. Dark Bomb would be brilliant for that room, but Dark Bomb is not here. Dark Bomb's never here. Dark Bomb, where were you when I needed you the most? Dark Bomb, we were brothers in arms. You have betrayed me. Why Have You Forsaken Me, a Joker card. That's exactly what I asked for. 2020, brilliant. Especially with our low Azazel range, if we can kill something before it gets too close, we're going to feel so much better about it. Like, in this situation, we could simply just get caught by those things. I'm okay with not. End this room, we may get some consumables. Alright, so that 2020 pickup is basically, is literally doubled our DPS. To the extent that I'm no longer worried about getting too close to enemies, because I think we should be able to kill most enemies before they actually pose a threat when they are nearby us. So let's go to the next floor. We are at 12, nearly 13 minutes. We're about to enter the Necropolis 2. This is considerably faster than the daily run. And we've actually lasted a little bit longer in our lives than we did on the greed mode accidental run that we started this with. But we're still looking for Crown of Light, which I'd forgotten about, actually. Honestly, I just wanted to play this game. Crown of Light comes from Angel Rooms. We haven't found Chaos, so we're not going to get it on this run, unfortunately. But you know, it's got to the stage where I just want to play the game and then determine whether I give a shit about Crown of Light. If we happen to get Angel Rooms, we happen to get Angel Rooms. We get Chaos. We get Chaos. That was an excellent fight. I'm very happy to fight Envy if Envy dies in one hit. We don't know where we're going, so we just do the standard. You're in a maze and don't know where you're going, and follow the right-hand wall. Follow the right-hand wall. Cookie's tail has actually... That was a pretty good room, because that just showed us a secret room, which means we don't have to pay to get out. No, I don't want the troll bomb that follows me. Do I want this? Now, cancer trinket is usually... I think we do, but the cancer trinket is usually probably the best or second best trinket in the game. Ooh. Because it doubles your rate of fire. I think the only reason I'm happy to at least experiment with the cancer trinket as Azazel with Brimstone is that we're really not getting much at all out of Black Feather. Found the mom fight. We haven't found our item room yet, so we want to do that. We've got more than enough time, so there's no excuse for laziness here. Might even play this. What do we expect to get? A penny. Brilliant. I do love that effect. And we got a spirit heart for blowing it up, so kudos to me for making the right decision. Got lucky on this cursed room for it letting us out for free. There's a troll bomb there. Don't walk into it. But we are basically set. More range would not be the worst thing in the world, but we don't need it. More spirit hearts, more bombs. All of this is perfect. Our bombs are killing everything, so if we get particularly upset, we put a bomb down and hide somewhere where it won't get us. And wait for it to explode. We have found the arcade. I think we'll do nothing for us unless we can find invincibility, but you know, never say never. I was hoping that that bomb would get everything in here. A luck upgrade from a penny. That's lovely. A bomb for a luck upgrade. I don't know what the luck upgrade magnitude is, but we got it, so there's that. Where's my item room at? Where your head at? You die. I think having the cancer trinket is allowing us to brim snap so much more cromulently. But I'm happy to have it. Another black heart. Oh, it's a red heart. Never mind. Because it means that any shot that doesn't completely kill the enemy, we can just charge up another one basically straight away and deal with it. That was an easy room. It's going so fast. It's so nice to have an Azazel run after these almost train wreck. They weren't train wreck runs. We did get some decent DPS upgrades on the daily run, but it wasn't enough to do a hush fire, and I should have known that. Hematemesis. That would be nice to know had we already known it, because we could use it on a super secret room and get loads of HP or something. Capricorn all stacks up slightly faster, a little bit more damage, and some HP. So I don't really need to go this way because we found our item room, which is the only reason we did go that way. But yeah, being able to charge this brimstone laser in basically no time at all is a lot more valuable than the possible scant amount of damage we were getting from the black feather, if any at all, because I'm not sure. I think the pentagram counts as an evil item, so we do have some. Is it this way? I think it might not be. I think it might be. Sacrifice a key to the key gods. That's the way Northern Lion teaches us. Down here? I was just having a look in that... just buy that card. We've got 31 cents. We're not going to use it on the rest of the High Priestess. No, that's no good. All right, let's do this. We're not going to use our money from now on, so we might as well spend it. Trying to get the mom fight. They're definitely making boss rush. Hello? There you are. Especially with Red Mom just giving us the fight, basically. That's easy. Small Rock? Nope. Spirit Hearts, but they may be useful. I don't know. I was going to say afterwards, but of course we're not fighting boss rush. Don't want that. Don't want... no, don't want that. I think Little Brim is exactly what we want for the simple reason that... Ooh. I didn't consider this eventuality, by the way. We want Little Brimstone because it has infinite range, which basically compensates for our major malfunction right now. And the fact that we have permanent Polaroid invincibility for this Demon Judgment means that we can basically give it as much HP as we care to without worrying about it too much. And there's Spun, so I'm happy with that. Hematemesis in here is no good. Blank Rune actually rerolled everything, which is super good because it means we get the mark. I don't think I want Missing Page 2. It's no real use for anybody. And we get our HP back, so that's really good. You got Horror Babylon back, which I'd actually forgotten that we lost by taking the HP in the first place. We have Mapping but no Compass, so I'm guessing we go straight down here. We could use our money on that, but it seems like... I feel like I'm a bit too lazy, so I'm not going to. I will take the key, because we're going to go to the chest. No! I nearly forgot that he did a cross. There we go. And, yeah, we've got Horror Babylon back as a result of spending the HP. We accidentally... What am I going this way for? We accidentally spent... our red HP on... It's clearly not down here, because what I didn't realise is that there's a little small room at the end. We accidentally spent our red HP on a decent item instead of the shit items, because we got a blank room because we spent all our HP on the Demon Judgment. Okay, apparently I'm playing this guy, so let's just do it. And we got Little Brimstone from Boss Rush, which we didn't do. So that last floor was actually super valuable for us. Come on. Pay out with something I want, i.e. not an HP upgrade. Compass would be great, actually. Give me the compass. Give me the compass for a modern world. Girl. Give me the compass with the modern girl. Because it's give me the future with the modern girl? You know this song. Everyone knows that. Obviously. Who did it and what was it? 48-hour energy. Well, I got another battery from the thing that I used a battery charge to do. 3 keys. Why not? Why the fuck not? So we can stand back and use Little Brimstone, or we can get up close and basically one-shot everything anyway. And also, Nightlight turns out to have been an actually savvy pickup, because it means that anything that gets too close to us is slowed down to give us the time to kill it before it gets even more too close to us and possibly explode. And of course, we've got these bombs, which are OP as all fuck. Yeah, we're out of here. Skull X. Just put this down. Yes! We'll take that afterwards, because it means we can buy these, which I will. Well, I will. Well, I will. Mr. Dolly is a tears upgrade? Yes. Which doesn't really help us, but it's nice to have the spirit hearts. We haven't got any money, so we can't complete that judgment, but honestly, who cares? We are going to win. We're at 19 minutes on the Womb 2, so we're definitely fast enough for Hush, because we could still get into boss rush now, even if we had the opportunity. I'm guessing that the boss fight is this way. I'm going to press the button, press the button, press the button. Yeah, no, don't want that. Oh, we've been here. I already understand this puzzle game. You don't need to test me twice. Test me once, shame on you. Test me twice, Ed's watching. Ed has no idea what's going on. Ed, why? It's pretty simple. Alright, let me break it down for you. See this? This is me, the character that moves. I have to go through room to room and not die. Do you now understand? Answers is fine for the next floor. Blank Rune turns out to be Hagalaz, which is nothing for us. Dagars is useful now. It wasn't. Perthrow, I will take because we may end up with a deal with the devil. And we can reroll it. Or that room. If we don't get a deal with the devil, maybe we get a Yara Rune in there. If not, I think we take Perthrow. Dodge these. No deal with the devil. I'm not doing Hush because I'm salty about the Hush today. Yara. It is Yara. Alright, cool. We'll take that. See ya, game. 21 minutes. Up to the cathedral. Brilliant. There's no way we lose. I think it's probably at that limb of the map on the bottom right. Loki, you walked into me, you joker. That's alright. We're going to get that HP back. Bit of a silly piece of damage, but I mean, no one cares. We also have Succubus bouncing around the room, who is going to basically kill anything I can't get near. Give me something. Didn't. Pill. Tears down. Not useful. We're firing so fast. I was correct. And we're doing so much damage with each shot that basically Isaac here has also no chance to survive make this time. Well, that was a bit of a shit situation to be in because I couldn't move without taking damage. And if I didn't move, I took damage. So we... two spirit hearts on one floor. I think that floor literally took 45 seconds. If that. We use our Yara rune, don't forget. That's always fun. What do we win? Yes, that is Spun. We already got Spun. Okay. I don't want Keybagger. I might as well take Lost Fly. Might as well take Sackdag. Sackdag's pretty cool. Loki's Horns cannot be bad for me right now. I don't want Cursed Eye or that item. And Lusty Blood could be good for us too. Though Lusty Blood... it's more useful early on when there's multiple enemies on a particular room because it resets every room. I don't really care for that. We might be able to reroll that, so I'm going to keep it around for now. Drat. Hoping to have killed Gurdy before Gurdy fired at me, but it did not happen. 8-inch nails is just a straight damage upgrade, and that's dead. This could be the fastest run I've had in such a long time that it will... rekindle my morale and make me want to play the next run, in which I'm actually going to try and find the final item that we need. The Hermit card. I mean, we could just use it and try and get closer to the boss. Tears down again. There's like three pills in this rotation, and I'm only getting one of them. It took us marginally closer to what might be the boss, but probably isn't. Right now I think about it, there's not much chance that's the boss. What's this? High Priestess. No. Two of Diamonds. Fine. Yeah, that's not the boss. Okay. Are you dead? No. Why not? Move. Good. Misjudged that. So, to deal with that, you want to make sure you stay orthogonal to it until it starts moving. Obviously. Obviously. Right. So, it's probably over there on the right. A penny. Wow. It's going to be super useful to us. I'm so fast. I'm so fast. I'm running into rooms and just walking into the bad guys. What are you doing? Can't see the baddie. There we go. I'm gonna sneeze. I hope that's okay with everybody. Just give me a minute. Hold on. There we go. Oh, that's a good one. Ooh, clears your sinuses right out. I guess that's the point. Shouldn't really talk like I'm surprised by that. This is not a great room. But at least we can one-shot the bloat, and the bloat is probably one of the most annoying enemies in the game. I have lost most of my HP, though, on this floor, so that was not very smart. I'm playing recklessly, and I know, but at the same time, I can basically one-shot the boss with a bomb. So I'm gonna... in fact, let's do that. If we just put this here, like this, and then hide here... ta-da! Well, thank you for watching that episode, people on YouTube and people on Twitch. Stick around, there's going to be more, and this time I might actually try and do what I'm here